Rise. Whatever it is, she's happy. That's probably what it is.
Yeah, that's what you think.
Dear friends, we've come together this evening in the presence of God and His general revelation outside a beautiful place for a moment. We've come to join Susan, Michelle, Tamara, and Gregory and Lee Mass in the bond of marriage. We're here to rejoice with them during this time. Marriage is a gift of God's and rules of His grace, in which man and woman become one flesh. We're told in Genesis that a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his tall wife, and the two shall become one. It is God's purpose that his husband and wife give themselves to each other in love. They shall grow together and be united in that love. The union of man and woman in heart, body, and mind is intended for their mutual comfort and health, that they may know each other with delight and tenderness and acts of love, and that they may be blessed in the procreation, care, and upbringing of children, should they choose to do so. The married husband and wife give themselves to each other to care for each other in good times and in bad times. They are linked to each other's families, and they begin a new life together in community. It is a way of life that all should reverence and none should take lightly. But Susan, remarriage is intended to join you for life and relationship so intimate and personal that it will change your whole being. God offers you the hope and indeed the promise of a life that is true. Susan, you have Greg to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Greg, will you have Susan to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her, as long as you both shall live? Who presents Greg to be married to Susan?
We do.
All right, great. Would you step up right here? Now can be seated. Who presents Susan to be married to Greg?
We do.
All right, now come with Pastor Harold and Greg. Welcome, go sit down too. Okay, now, I have a question for all of you gathered here. Now, I was born and raised in the South, so the plural of y'all is all y'all. Got that? So here's the question. Will all y'all do everything in your power to support and uphold this marriage in the years ahead? And your answer is, we will.
We will.
Thank you. That's a great affirmation. Because no one lives in a marriage by themselves. It's husband, it takes wife, and it takes a community of friends and family to make it happen. Let's pray. Loving and beloved God, from the beginning, you've made us to live in partnership with one another. Your generous love surrounds us, and everything we need joy comes from you. In your great love, you've given us the gift of marriage. We pray for the presence of your Spirit with Susan and Greg as they pledge their lives to each other. May their love always continue to grow and be the true reflection of your love for us all. Fill their hearts with sincerity and truth as they enter this solemn covenant. Amen. Susan are going to do now is called a sand ceremony. What they're going to do is they're going to come here. They're going to take their sand. Make sure we have the right colors for the right picture. And what they're going to do is pour their sand together. Symbolizing as just as these sands can no longer be separated, so they're committing and covenant together that their life will be together till one of them lays the other end of the grave.
All right, now they're together. It's like they're at one.
yourselves to each other in this joyous and act of sacred covenant together. Become one, fulfill your promises, love and serve God and one another. You go firm before God and your families and your friends, you're bound to love and commitment. You come from different backgrounds, you've walked different paths. You're different individuals. Your love has transcended these differences, and in the years before you, may the richness of the traditions that you have nurtured you enhance and brighten your lives and the lives of others as you help to create and shape. By their promises made before us and before God this evening, Susan and Greg have united themselves as husband and wife in sacred covenant. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Let's pray. Great eternal God, creator and preserver of the soul, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon Greg and Susan, whom we bless in your name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your ways. Look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, and cherish each other, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and through godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and a place of peace. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May God look upon you with kindness and give you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege now to present to you Mr. and Mrs. See, I saw you, she's there. Mr. and Mrs. Greg and Susan Mass. You may not kiss your bride. This evening with the traditional breaking of the glass. The breaking of the glass, like the commitment that they have made today, is irrevocable and permanent. As the groom breaks the glass, I invite every one of you to greet them with mazel tov, which means congratulations and good luck.
Right. Sure.
All right. Susan, thank you for coming this evening. We invite you to go into the reception straight away. It's in the Emerald Ballroom. If you would make your way there, they're going to take some pictures. Our worship is ended. Go in peace. May the God of love and peace go with you.